is going to play on this, and it seems like aggression is going to be the name of the game.
Full clear by that Roomba. Looks like they'll just blow up a little bit of utility, and there's Sinatra already in position. Looking for a few kills right behind the gate. Actually wastes that clip, and he's not going to be able to get two as he gets hit by the splash from the grenade of Corey. And now it looks like Hookah may be the take. A bit of rotation coming in from Sentinels as they're moving quick here, and it's not going to take very much more. Shazam picks up the Ghost 3K, and the Spectre firms up.
Statistically, that was never...
For now, and play a little bit more defense after adding this initial pressure.
Ooh. Big, big kills there for Zachary and Marv. That's massive. Now they should be able to get on site. They'll also be able to get some guns, too. And they'll have the numbers advantage. So a free plant here by A. Well, not necessarily free in the sense that they didn't do much for it, because they had to do a lot to make this happen. And there's Marv, ever reliable, at Heaven to support. Sinatra, though, looking to take space instantly here. And Sick, you know, Sick is, I think, one of the best players, if not the best player in the game. His agent pool is ridiculous. So the fact that him and Sinatra are still alive could be bad news for FaZe if they're not careful.
That was a little dinky. I love that you say that, Golden Boy, because when we saw the team talking about Sick, the Swiss Army knife of that squad, he can do everything, and they love to see him alive. They love to see him as the last one, and he's able to get so many damn kills while doing it. And obviously, like you said, Sinatra's on the other side. There before, it was all contact coming from Dapper's camera. Really didn't need to happen, but one for one's now going to mix things up. We'll see if the Showstopper can make it work. And it looks like it's held now just for a little bit of displacement of where Sentinels can be coming from. A fire torch. Bonnie finds Shazam! Alt for alt, and he gives him back a little bit of his own medicine on the round.
Sick is looking for the target here. Does he end up locating it? And it does.
Oh my word.
Landing a huge kill on the Baby Bay. Now Zachary, as he picks up two kills of his own inside of Lamps, it is just going to be left down to Sick, but Sick could very well clutch it. He's going to go in for this, but there's the Hunter's Fury to slow things down. Time continues to tick. He cannot do it. As good as Sick is, that was going to be a tall task to ask of him, and that is going to be the round. FaZe finally get their first on the board, Riv.
Golden Boy, this is one of the things I love about Valorant. It looks like a swing. And the orb grab over towards that. Hey, that's a bad spot to be. Gets smoked in Hookah, and FaZe executes on B beautifully. Wrong about the A hit here, Golden Boy. I was way wrong as they slow work it towards B, and these slow rounds again paying off for FaZe against Sentinels.
Well, this shows us that FaZe clearly have been putting in the work. You know, when you're going up against Sentinels, there is no world where you could just wing it, right? This team has won too many events. They've had so much success, and there's so much talent on this roster that you need to have a deep playbook. So for FaZe, being able to slow work this round the way that they are, everything that I'm seeing right now from FaZe is extremely impressive from them. But Sentinels, you know, they're doing the thing that we know that they're capable of doing, and that's shutting down FaZe in those really fast-paced and intense rounds. So FaZe decides, we're going to shift things up. We're going to go a little quieter, and we're going to see what the results are. And so far, it's so good.
And that was a bit of my question for FaZe. Does Marv bite it?
No.
Nope. Not at all.
Not happening. I appreciate the five-head play, though, you know? I really do, but it just wasn't happening.
Rock is now right there on the back. Looks like they're actually going to want to take this. Give me a corpse. He finds that on Sinatra, and they're going to be able to read this one. Do they still commit here? Just towards the back of the site, a spray goes through, and that may change their mind for a moment until some more util can tell them what's going on.
And they know that they're going to have to deal with Dapper in the back line here, and I just don't think, he was not in a position to be able to handle that effectively. So they'll get this spike down over here at B. Spike planted. Sick and Zoms. Not a lot really in the inventory. One paranoia that Zoms could potentially use. So the Dark hovers to break off Hookah, and then he's more than likely going to hit that. Yep, right here, the paranoia, and then here comes the push. But what he wasn't prepared for was the fact that there was a player behind him when he exited from defender side, and Sick is now just going to be trapped here at elbow with really no options.
Oh, Rockus ready for the peak. And they were ready at every angle, and almost tied up first half here.
Getting into Marv, so the commitment here on B site is intelligent. Zachary with a connection as soon as he makes his way out of Hookah. Another one there for Corey. Maybe two here to boot, but it's instead you got Sick and Dapper working together, getting those frags now. A 2v3, but the bigger guns are going to be on the side of FaZe, but it seems like it doesn't matter when you have that many shots beaming right at you.
Yeah, Zachary now in the 3v1. Tagged right away. Fight with the dart in ya. Just go for it. Almost takes the blast pack quick. Not too much damage. Yeah, you won't. And this is always such a tough angle. You don't know if they're B-mate, Hookah, hitting in the cubby. There's one, and it's going to be a peek by Dapper off contact onto Sick. He does. And a lot of times, you know, it is true that being at the bottom, there it is. You ask, they deliver. Being at the bottom isn't bad because you can be offering utility and things in other ways. But as a duelist, you want to get those alt points. You can't always be in the spot to farm orbs at the beginning of the round so you can run out different strats. And if you're not getting Bladestorm, you're not being that effective. So seeing him get kills now is huge for FaZe. They continue to open up as Zachary comes out of showers. And now U-Haul has quite a bit lit up here. See if they can
the take amount
that.
Of bodies inside of you, old man. You know you don't want to deal with that. Stare right at them as they come through. But here come the kills. Only player left alive there was
don't
simply
put all
just
your eggs in one U-Haul.
Yeah, one player by Garden. Shazam making magic happen as he takes out Baby Bay. But Corey's going to be lurking there. Does manage to get a kill onto Dapper. Watch out though; those blast packs will take you out if you're not careful. But it'll certainly be Zom's Phantom that gets the job done. As soon though, as Sick exits out of Hookah, Raucus was waiting for him in that corner, and you always want to check that corner. And I think that maybe that Hunter's Fury could have come out to be able to assist a bit sooner. Either way though, Sentinels with two players left alive, they're still in this one. Shadows
traveling. There's a lot committed to this round for Sentinels right here. If they actually don't get this, it could
left.
Be tough. Oh, chuck it. Just give it to me. They know he's in. All right, so they know how one's being played. This could actually be a spam in, but he's going to take the shot towards Hookah. Does he stop planning? No. Shazam's going to plant. Has about 10 HP to his name. It's just going to be a jumping classic. But Shazam gets the 3K, and now it's the 2v1. Oh. Ruckus goes down. Shazam comes up huge with the help of Zoms.
And that's why you're seeing him not be as big of a factor here.
They seem to have his number, Golden Boy. He just can't get like a good position to find his game.
Yeah, yeah, it really is problematic here. And now another problem situation occurred there for Corey. He was going to be tucked away. Shazam just wins that one outright. And that's just a demoralizer there, folks. That hurts if you're Baby Bay. Now Marv, 1v2, still doable with 3 HP, still doable with 3... Actually, scratch that, 1v1 now, apologize there. Zachary was going to be the hero, didn't see him.
Yeah.
This is looking like we're going to get even more aggression. Right out of the gate, right? Dapper just walks freely right inside of Lamps. He knows that their guns aren't going to be good to deal with this, and he will continue to stall this one out. A valiant attempt by Baby Bay, but it is just not going to amount to all that much. Sinatra does not get the kill with the running back, but deals a hefty amount of damage there to Marv. Now we're going to have four players left alive, and everyone's going to be banged up as Corey swings, gets the kill.
Uh-oh.
Watch out Shazam, though. He's down to 37 HP, and everyone's just worse for wear here. They're getting all beat up. It's a slugfest, and that's why the spike is going to be taken all the way to the B site.
They signed a contract on this one. If you walk into U-Haul, you must be pressing mouse one the whole time. That was intense, Golden Boy. Spike's going to be planted here at B. A nice switch by Zoms. And again, they have the B main hold. Nothing to wall that off. Nothing to smoke that off right now. It's only the camera for Zachary on the retake. They may be able to use that to get an idea of how to play this. But it's the HP is not looking good for either side, really. Better for Sentinels, though.
But what they do have is a paranoia. The moment the movement happens, expect that paranoia from Zoms. And that is going to be a determining factor here. Once they hear noise, it's going to connect onto Zachary and Corey. It may not even need to happen. Oh, wait a minute, though. There goes the paranoia and the swing. The swing happens. And unfortunately for Sentinels, but a big shot there. And there is the final clutch by Red Bull.
Aiden. Sinatra's just making sure there's no long flank on this one.
Now, always become challenging with the classics, as even right-click being as powerful as it is, to retake that against the guns, the stronger weapons that Sentinels had was always going to be difficult. But once again, they will also be able to place this spike here at B. Now with Marv'd in play, you get a curveball to enter into the site and peek the corners. But Zoms was wise to that one and was also prepared for the try. Having one Hawk left, this flash will obliterate these two players here.
Oh my word.
And here comes the push. But Marv was actually gonna for it! He gets three kills there. Not enough to end the round though. Now Zoms.
30 seconds left.
They'll get this spike down. Two players left alive for FaZe, Baby Bay and Raucus. Do they have any utility? They have one paranoia to retake this.
Spike planted.
Oh, I love smart. They're gonna hold hands out here in the defender side.
They can definitely hear the utility going into sight, so they have an idea that they're going to have to go back in now. Zoms, now they start to split. Zoms has low HP, Sinatra's full against two full HP of Baby Bay and Raucus. Beautiful vault line, or fault line coming in from Baby Bay, seeing this breach from him for the first time in competition. He looks towards B main, and that's not the spot, but now Raucus has the intel. He knows, and it's not going to be enough as he goes for Zoms, and he's tricked by Sinatra.
I know exactly where you
are. Oh, that makes things real difficult to know exactly where the defenders are coming from.
Oh, and it's just Shazam, he's in everything. He's peeling. I'm sorry, he's peeling, folks. This is Shazam's game. Oh! He's disgusting. He's going for another one. He's going to hit it. Watch. Check it out. In the corner. I have confidence, I believe. Oh! Okay, if I did though, I would have sounded like a genius. Anyway, Zachary though, trying to keep himself in this, or at the very least get some exits. Because time is certainly going to be ticking here, and I think walking away with the up, yeah, that's a small win for this one.
Yeah.
Had he hit it though, Riv? Had he hit it?
Mm-hmm.
I would have been
a threat about you.
That would have been, well, no, definitely not a threat about me.
Usually in as that controller, or whatever he's been playing.
That wolf is going to make life very difficult for anyone that wants to follow up on a flash with Sky in play. Oh, Rolling Thunder actually is going to be used, and Zachary was not prepared for another player to be located on the side, and Marv is going to swing through for three of his own. A quick round there from FaZe. I thought it could have been a little...
Rounds, GB.
It's always nice when the child is going to contribute. But they went aggressive into A, and they had no other choice, right? You just have Singers, Spectres, right? No real weapons to use here. That's why you got to play this one close. And last one left alive is going to be Zoms on site with this Stinger. You're going to be able to get one kill, but if they're smart, they're going to trade this one off instantly. And he doesn't even do that. They still manage to nail it. And that is going to be FaZe coming back into this game, Riv.
Yeah.
A critical swing for FaZe that have now made them competitive on split.
So this change for Baby Bay becomes a paradigm shift in the fact that he's very slow, and FaZe has, as we said, FaZe before was peak and vents, peak and top, and they were giving him a bit to look at, but now FaZe is waiting back, and it's causing some troubles for Sentinels.
So smart there. So smart to hold that one, but unfortunately follow up with another kill. Baby Bay, though, bit scattered on that shot, but it is going to land the target, and then he follows through with a third shot there, thus bringing him within one.
They were sight in FaZe's favor.
They know that they have bodies up on top of heaven. Sinatra's going to make his way down low as Sick is going to join in and pick up a kill. Three frags as if it was nothing. Marv trying to keep the drive alive here, but it is not meant to be. Zachary on the flank tried to pull what Sentinels did in that last round. It was a smart play to make, but just not really what you want.
Frag to start this round off.
They'll be okay, though, as far as vision blocking is concerned, not losing Raucus early in the round. Although having the multitude of flashes that Breach provides would have been a huge plus here for FaZe.
30 seconds left.
Now they're going to have to make a swing happen, and Shazam's got them red. There goes the coverage. Here comes the smoke, and actually a well-timed push. As soon as that dark cover dropped, they ended up playing against their own dark cover, which is so smart here, but now Sick tucked in the corner. He'll be all right. That's three kills for Sick, and even to do so, he's going to be the guy that I'm really focused on here, because if he gets this kill, it will open things up greatly for them. And he will, because Shazam was prepared for it. Now here comes the push. They know where the op is, so they can at least play around this information, but Corey now is just going to be trapped inside of a cyber cage. No options, no time, flawless, presented by Prime Gaming. This is it. Match point.
takedown of the site defense once FaZe was in it. That was awesome by Sentinels, and we're really seeing them start to flex a little bit where they know they want these rounds and this match
to be over. Yeah, and in this position, Riv, with that Odin, yeah, that ain't gonna happen. Also, good luck trying to take out the op up on Heaven there. And there's Sinatra again. He's looking, it's match points, series points. Sinatra's looking to flank with an Odin. 2020 is a crazy year. Corey doesn't want to have any of those shenanigans, and he's gonna stop it right in his tracks. The Odin is down, but there's another flanker potentially pushing forward here. Here goes the rocket. Boom, it connects. That should be a moment for them to push up on B, but instead they're going to play this one slowly, but right into the loving hands of Sick. And Sick gets one. He's looking for one more. He's going to get the flash. No, he doesn't. He does have an inclination, though, that he is going to be in that corner. That's why he's just going to back up the Rolling Thunder so that Baby Bay can get some space and get control here. I just don't think control is an option when dealing with Sentinels.
Great turns coming in. They're trying to test each other as much as possible here as the spike will be planted over A from Zachary. Baby Bay is just giving the other members hell here. And they get the rotation on. Now this means Baby Bay will not be there as he picks up a Phantom to get there with Zachary Golden Boy. This could be the round. He has to run.
He has to fly here. Zachary has a lot of work in front of him. Can he find one kill as two players are going to swing him at the same time? And now it's down to Baby Bay. Does he spam through this one here? Does manage to get one kill. Halfway for Shazam. Get the second kill. But can he get the third? And no, he cannot. Sentinels.